वेलकम। टुडे विल रेज्यूम द लर्निंग अबाउट द डिजाइनिंग ऑफ ए प्रेजेंटेशन यूजिंग बीमर इन लेटेक। दिस इज द सेम प्रेजेंटेशन विच वी क्रिएटेड इन द लास्ट ट्यूटोरियल एंड इन दिस वीडियो विल कंप्लीटली फॉर्मेट दिस फॉर बेटर अपीयरेंस। दिस इज द सोर्स फाइल। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई टॉक अबाउट थीम्स। द बीमर क्लास यूजेस फाइव डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ थीम्स। फर्स्ट वन इज ग्लोबल थीम्स। ये प्रेजेंटेशन और ग्लोबल थीम डिक्टेट्स फॉर एवरी सिंगल डिटेल ऑफ ए प्रेजेंटेशन व्हाट इट लुक्स लाइक। फॉर एग्जाम्पल द नंबर्स इन एन्यूमरेशन, व्हाट कलर दे हैव, व्हाट कलर देयर बैकग्राउंड हैज, व्हाट फॉन्ट इज यूज टू रेंडर देम, वेदर ए सर्कल आर ए बॉल आर ए रेक्टेंगल आर वॉट एवर इज ड्रॉन बिहाइंड देम एंड सो फोर्थ। इन द प्रेजेंट ट्यूटोरियल आई एम गोइंग टू यूज ए मैड्रिड थीम एज ए ग्लोबल थीम with the sec header option. The reason for using this theme is that the appearance of the lists, which I like most. This is the appearance when East Lansing theme is used. And this is with the Madrid theme. Here I have a Beamer appearance cheat sheet. This can be downloaded from C10 website. We can see all the available themes at this place. Next one is inner themes. Inner themes include all the elements that are at the inside of the frame, means which are not part of the headline, footline or sidebars. Inner themes mainly include all enumerations, itemized environments, block environments, theorem environments or the table of contents. The available Beamer inner themes we can see in the cheat sheet. Now bullet style has been changed. Next one is outer theme. Outer themes mainly dictate the elements outside of the frame, whether it could be sidebar, it could be headline or it could be footline. It changes the style of such elements, for example sidebar. Now we have a left sidebar. Next one is color themes. Color themes only dictate which colors are used in a presentation. It changes the color of a global theme. Beamer offers several color themes we can use, for example this one. We can use a custom color. For this, just use a structure in curly bracket and in optional bracket just write the name of the color, named, equal sign and color name. I'll define one color, burgundy. Just write this custom name. Last one is font themes. A font theme specifies which font or fonts attributes are used in a presentation. The available font themes we can see in the cheat sheet. Using this option we can print all the titles in boldface. I am going to use a serif font. Color, font and style of any element of a presentation we can change using three commands: set Beamer font, set Beamer color and set Beamer template. One term, that is an element, I am often repeating. Actually an element in Beamer is a part of the presentation, that is potentially typeset in some specific way. We can see all the elements in Beamer cheat sheet. These are all elements: title page, part page, section page, headline, footline, sidebar left, sidebar right and so on. In addition, insert like commands are also available. These are also elements. Now I want to print a title element in boldface. For this we can use a set Beamer font command. Element name is title. For the boldface use a series. equal sign and df series command. We can also change the size equal sign large command. All right, similar setting we can do for the other elements, author. Institute, date in boldface, now we'll change the color of title element, foreground and background using the set beamer color command. For background color use BG option, equal sign and color name. For foreground use FG. Author. For author I only want to change foreground color. Institute. For institute I want to use burgundy. Okay. Now go to next slide. In the footline, I want to change the background color of each element. We can do this using set beamer color command. Element is author in head foot. Background color. Title in head foot. Date in head foot. Here in the right side, date and frame number both are coming in the same box. I want to print these two elements in a separated box. For this, we can use a set beamer template command. Element name is footline. In second curly bracket, we can define the footline. For printing the element with color box, we need to use a beamer color box environment. Write each element name. First one is author, author in head foot. Here we need to use insert like command, insert sort author. Similarly for the title, insert sort title. Then date. One more box we need to add for the frame. Just write a page number in head foot. Insert frame number forward slash insert total frame number. We can also define the width and height of each box. After begin beamer color box, in optional bracket just write WD for the width, equal sign, and define the width. Height I am taking 7 point. You can use a smaller or larger value for a smaller or larger height. We can set the alignment. Other options are left and right. We have to divide the total width on the scale of 1. So for the author, I am taking 0.3, 0.38, 0.22. And for the frame numbering, I am taking 0.1. Before begin beamer color box, we need to use one command. Either we can use hbox or we can use leave vmode command. It's coming, but something is still need to be set. Actually each box is taking one blank space. So after end beamer color box, just use a percentage symbol. We can change the background of a page number. Just use set beamer color, page number in head foot, color name, and also we can print all the titles in footline in boldface. After leave v mode, use bf series command. Here we can make a vertically center alignment using depth option. For depth, DP option is used. Let us check with 2.5 point. All right. Here after author name, we can insert institute name. In round brackets, just write insert sort institute. Set Beamer template with footline element creates one problem for the appendix page number. Here appendix frame numbers are counted into total frame numbers. We want to exclude the appendix frame numbers. This command is not working. We need to use one package. Appendix number beamer. Now appendix is corrected. Similar to footline, we need to correct headline. Here in the right side, I want to print all the sections name. And in the left side, I want to print a running section name. Again, we have to use a set beamer template. Element is headline. Write section in head put. And at this place, just write insert section head. For the running head, I'll take 0.25 of the total paper width. For printing all the sections, we have one command, insert section navigation horizontal. This command accepts three arguments. First one is for the width, same width I'll take. Second one is the setting for the pre-text, and last one is the setting for the post-text. Here we can use any palette. There are four palettes in Beamer. Primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. These colors are already defined with Beamer. I am taking palette quaternary. We can change the color of headline. Set Beamer color. Section in head foot. Similarly, palette color. Next setting is frame title. I want to print all the frame titles in bold face. Just write set Beamer font. Element is frame title. BF series. Now go to next slide. We can change the margins. Also left margin of the frame title. Sort references are not coming. Just compile BibTeX and then PDF LaTeX. Now references are coming. Here we can set the color for the reference. I'll define one new color. Then find old bib command. At this place, just write the color name. Also, I want to print in boldface, BF series. We can also suppress the navigation symbols. Write set Beamer template, navigation symbols. No need to write anything in the second curly bracket. Alright. Here I want to print the numbers in round brackets. We need to use a set Beamer template command. Element name is enumerate item. Inside curly bracket, use round bracket. And inside that, just write / Arabic. In curly bracket, write enum i. I for the label 1. Similarly, we can do for the sub item. In the same way, we can do for the bulleted list. I want to use a tick symbol. With the help of Pi font package, we can use a number of symbols. So just load this package, Pi font. And here just write backslash ding. In curly bracket, we need to write number. This package offers all these symbols. We have to just use the number. Now in this slide, I want to use one nested list. We need to change the font size for the level 2 and level 3 lists. For this, we need to use a set beamer font command. Itemize slash enumerate body. I want to use footnote size. It's always better to put all the similar commands at one place so that we can search easily. Similarly, we can do for the level 2 subbody, level 3 subbody. It's a good idea to use a full frame. So for this, we can use a vfill command. We can also print the figure label at the center. After defining the column width, just use a centering command. Here I want to use one image in the right side, and the left side I want to print some text. This can be created using columns environment, but here I have used a mini page environment. No need to use a headline or footline for this frame. Just use a plain option. First column with the help of mini page. I have used a block environment. Then I have put the items inside itemized environment. And this is the image. This image I want to include. So I'll put this folder in the same working directory. And also we need to give the path, graphics path. Write the folder name and forward slash. Here I have used some fancy symbols And these symbols work with the one package. Go to preamble and load font awesome package. In the next, I want to shift this logo at the top in the same line and at the right side of the frame title. For this, we have to use one package, text pause. This time we have to use add to beamer template command, element frame title. This is the setting for the pre-text, no need to write anything. And this one is for the post text. So after frame title, we have to add the logo. In this bracket, we can make the setting. Just write start version of a text block environment, begin text block, end text block. Just provide the value of h size, that is horizontal size, in the curly bracket. I'm taking 100 mm. Then we have to use one pair of round brackets in which we can set the position with x and y coordinates. First one is the x position. For placing the object at the rightmost, we can use a line width command. Add the image using include graphics command. Now we need to change the y position. For moving upward, we need to use a negative value. Let us check with the 9 mm. I want to shift the logo to the left side a little bit. So rather than using full line width, I'll use a little bit smaller, 0.99. We can also change the box height of the frame title. Set beamer template, element is frame title. At this place, just write insert frame title. Adjust the spacing with the help of vskip and hskip commands. The white spacing between headline and frame title we can remove using no interline skip command. Also, I'll shift the frame title to the right side. Before insert frame title, we can use strut command. This logo we need to remove. Here in the headline, appendix title can also be printed. Just use start version of section command. Default alignment is fully justified. We can make a center justified. Now go to your headline setting. And here in the second curly bracket, which is for the pre-text setting, use hfill command. Just use the same command in the last bracket as well. All right. One small suggestion. If you want to emphasize something in your presentation, then you can highlight with the help of alert command. Now our presentation is looking very nice. In the last, we'll see some background settings. Here are few background images. First, I'll include a title background. So here at this place, just write set beamer template, background canvas, background image. Set the width and height as paper width and paper height. Background image name. In the title background image, I have already added logo, so this logo I'll remove. We can change the title, foreground and background colors. You can also change the theme if you don't like the shadow. This background image is coming in each frame. This one I want to use for all frames except a title frame. With the background image, you may have to change that layout. For example, here I want to change the frame title style so that I can see the text and horizontal red line. For the title frame, we can locally use this command. Go to your title frame and just place your background canvas and title frame inside curly bracket. We can see headline, footline and title style. Our preamble is looking very clumsy. We can put in a separated text file. Use include command. Create a text file with the name of preamble. Place all the preamble commands. Now I'll put this preamble and bibliography style files in the setting folder. Logo also I'll place in the setting folder. We need to set the path. This text file is in the setting folder and also path setting for this file. Now I'll stop this tutorial at this point. In the next part, we'll see a few more settings. Till then, bye bye. Thanks for watching.